None of us wants to be part of the generation that allows any of the cornerstones of rural England to fall off the cliff. So we truck on until it's not our turn anymore. The church and these cricket matches are far removed from any notions of religion itself. At the cricket, belief or genuine faith would be far too serious a subject to bring up in a tea tent conversation. Belief is of the utmost irrelevance in this context. We have a duty to support the church regardless. To everything there is a season, a time to reap and a time to sow. That peace which the world cannot give. Lighten our darkness. We have erred and strayed from thy ways like lost sheep. The language alone is worth saving. Words like rogation still have meaning here, surrounded by crops, in what is still referred to as a parish. There is a long collective memory involved in this ritual. 7 years of bumper crops, plagues of locusts, loaves and fishes, water into wine, a last supper, Lent, Ramadan, Diwali, feast and famine. Food is central to all religions, so the tea tent with its expert cake exhibitions seems an appropriate way to raise the necessary funds. We also run a bar and a barbecue all day. The cooking kit itself having evolved from a recycled tractor in the old days to a proper modern barbecue made out of an oil drum. On the raffle prize table, there are a few jars of homemade jam with a sign saying "Better than Bon Mammon" in Suffolk Franglais. Bun Mammon would accurately describe this cricket economy. Realistically, unless all these tiny rural churches can become something useful, they will soon become romantic ruins, as surely as our vanished clifftop church of St. Nicholas at Easton Bavance has fallen into the sea.